So welcome to Begin IT Career Online Trainings. Today we will see the detailed procedure, okay, the detailed procedure for the software development life cycle. Okay, what is this software development life cycle? So if you see any product, any software product, okay, there will be some step by step approach. So if you want to, so parallelly when I'm explaining a concept, I'll take an example of one practical website which we will be using it in a live. Okay, so for my entire reference, I'll be taking a website called irctc.co.in. This is my practical website which I am taking into reference. Okay, why am I taking this into references? When you want to develop any software product, it may be a website or it might be some other application. Okay, you will follow the same approach what we are dealing with software development lifecycle now. Okay, SDLC. So coming to that first step, if you see, to start with any kind of product or to develop any kind of thing, you want to know the requirement. So first step is requirement analysis. Okay, what is this requirement analysis? Looking at the term itself, you will gather requirements. That is a basic definition each and every person will come to know. Okay, so if it is a requirement analysis, how are we going to that? Going to do that? Who are the people involved in this requirement analysis? How do they collect the requirements? From whom are we collecting the requirements? These are the different kinds of questions which we arise. I mean, actually, we get these kind of questions. Until you work in that environment, you will not get a clear-cut information on this requirement analysis. Okay? So let us see in detail the first step of the software development lifecycle, requirement analysis. Okay, let us see what is this. So what is requirement analysis is, first step is a business analyst will be there. Okay, what is meant by business analyst is, for every company there will be a role called business analyst. Okay, so business analyst, what basically he will do is, he will go and talk to the customer. So now for example, in our application we have IRCTC. Okay, somebody gave this project to, so now Chaitanya is our business analyst. Okay, now I am giving, what I am saying is, I am the vendor. So I want to develop a product called IRCTC. And now Chaitanya is there. Now what am I asking is, now Chaitanya is a BA, business analyst for this project. So what he basically has to do is, now Chaitanya will book an appointment with me because I am the client here. So because I want to give a project to one company. So think that he is a business analyst from Tech Mahindra company. Okay. So what he will do, Chaitanya will book an appointment with me. I am a business owner here, client here. I am the client and he is the software company where I want to give my project to the Tech Mahindra. Okay. So now Chaitanya is from Tech Mahindra company. He is holding a role of business analyst and he booked an appointment with me. For what? He want to know the requirements of this particular application. I have something in my mind and I want to say that my application should look like this. I should have a login screen and when people are coming here, they want to book tickets and all these are my specifications to that product. So now Chaitanya will come to me. Okay. So once he is coming to me, I'll just say all the requirements, what I like in the product. Now because this product IRCTC is completely live, we are able to see this. But what now Chaitanya is coming and asking me requirements about the product, which is not in live at all. So I'm just giving some imaginations of my requirements. Is it clear till now? So now first step what he has done is, he went and approached, business analyst will go and approach the client for the requirements. Okay. Now what kind of requirements you will have? Requirements in the sense, suppose IRCTC is a product, everybody will go and book the tickets. They'll have a login screen. They will go, you can search for the trains. You can search for the tickets. You can book the tickets. You can log out. And you can cancel the ticket. You know what are the functionalities IRCTC basically have, right? So if I am going a bit fast, please stop me in between. So these are the requirements. Now the requirements are finalized. Okay, finalized in the sense, I told suppose 10 to 15 requirements to Chaitanya. He went back to his company, Tech Mahindra. Okay, example I am saying, I am not sure any company might be, any small software company. Okay, so once he has gone back to his company, his engagement manager or the business BRM. Okay, BRM is like, he'll be the top lead for the entire project. So he asked, Chaitanya, what are the requirements did you get from the client? He'll say, Chaitanya said that, yeah, I got the requirements and these are the list of requirements. He has showed a list of requirements what client has said. So that means what I said. So the BRM has gone through that requirements. He will see, like they'll have some basically bid. So they what they'll think is like, okay, for 15 requirements, we are going to charge you £1,000 or $1,000. It is based on their currency. So once the requirements he's given to that BRM, he will check that requirements and everything is perfect. What he'll say, you said 15 requirements and you gave 20 requirements. If there are more than 5 and this requirement is not properly given, that means we did not understand clearly. So they will just completely get the information about the requirements and the requirements will be frozen then and there. So have you understood like how they are conducting, how they are collecting basically the requirements from the customer? They'll go and get the information completely from the client, sitting with them, discussing with them, and once if it is matching with that rate and everything, they will finalize it. If there is any ambiguity in between, they'll go and ask for the more information. So once that is done, it is completely, the requirement gathering is done. Okay. So once when he is gathering the requirement, what he has done is he will prepare a document. That document, that there is a name for the document, that is called functional requirements. So this will be called in different ways to different in different companies. This is, they'll call you functional requirement specification, customer requirement specification, user document, business document. You will have different names for the document. So basically now the business analyst has a list of requirements in one single document, that is called functional specification document or customer requirement specification, some specification document. It is based on your company standards. You will call with some different names. So now only we have one name. So once the document is given to you, so that will be given to one. That document is prepared by business analyst when the client is giving his requirements. Okay. So next, what is happening is once that is done, business requirement specification, it is with business analyst. Now what he will do in the next stage, he will give it to some project manager, and what basically they will do is they will study the document. Why they have to study? Because you are not sure what kind of technology you have to use, how many people you have to invest to develop that complete product, what is the total requirements and how many days it will take. So everything you have to study on the requirements to give a complete detailed tentative plan, like when you will be delivering the product. Okay, so I'm not getting any questions. Is that clear or? Is it clear or is it fast? I'm not getting any questions. Okay. So coming to the roles, once the document is ready with us, what we basically do is we will just see the study. We will study the entire requirements document. So in which order we have to develop the product. So first we have to develop the login screen, or we have to develop the functionality, or that is booking a ticket or searching a ticket. They'll completely list out the proper approach. Okay. They'll just study the document and then they'll put the tentative dates when they have to deliver the product. So what technology they have to use, like Java, .NET or any other technology, struts, many different technologies we have, right? So out of that, which is the best technology they have to use to do this particular product, software product. So whether we can do the complete requirements or we have to do it in some phases. So everything they will decide in this particular process. So once the document is business requirement document, this study is done, they will divide that business requirement document, the first document, into software specific requirement specification, SRS. What is a software requirement specification? So basically this is like they will divide it into that business requirement document. It is an overall product. That complete product, they will divide it into different modules. Okay. So out of the different modules, they will, that means, see, business requirement document is a complete business. So we cannot deliver the complete business at first instance. So we will divide that entire document into subsections, like means sub parts, where we will divide it into sub phases. So first phase they have taken into another document called SRS, okay, software requirement specification. This is this first phase document where we have to consider only that 5 requirements. So out of that entire business means consider an example of ICICI Bank. Okay, ICICI Bank is supporting corporate, ICICI Bank is supporting personal, and it is giving some loans and it has many modules. Okay, the business is that ICICI CEO will say that I have to develop a website. Okay, she will have some imagination. She cannot mix all the loans with a personal bank account or all this stuff, right? So there will be a separate document for each and every section they actually do. So what will happen is, so now this separate, that means they have divided loans into separate section, personal banking into separate section, corporate banking into separate section. Now this SRS document, SRS will have a subsection of loans. Think that here we have only loan section. So out of that loans, what are the screens you have to get, how the functionality should be, they will divide this document separately again. So once you will have a complete requirement document, next now you have a separate SRS document, that is software requirement specification document. So this is a parent document for one application. That means they'll have different websites for different modules. So for one website, they have defined a separate SRS. Okay, clear? So once this SRS document is ready, okay, once it is done, so what we have to do is, they will have to give a clear cut information. What clear cut information they have to give is, so after you log in, suppose now I am taking a case of IRCTC, okay, once I log into IRCTC, what should happen is, the moment I log in, what is the screen it should display? Suppose if I am logging in, okay. Think that I have logged in. The moment I log in, okay, what is the screen it should display? It is displaying me some proceed for booking or update profile. So I should know the navigation screens from the first section to next section, second section to third section. Okay, so I should have the complete information of the navigation screen and each screen functionality. All these things, there should be a connection between them. So now what is happening here is, once I am preparing a software requirement specification document, I will have clear cut information on each and every screen. First screen should have username, password. The moment I click login, it has to go to plan my travel page. Here I will give to a station, from station and date. If I click search, it should take me the list of trains. It should give me the list of trains. Once I select a train and then click book, I should be able to book a ticket. So they'll give you with screenshots also. They'll develop some sample things, sample screens, and they will develop this screenshots as well. Okay. And they will pass this information to next level. So why is this very detailed information is required at this level? Because the client imagination is one thing, and finally what we have understood might be a different one. So after developing the complete project, what might happen is, the client will say that I did not give you this requirement, then why have you developed this? He might ask you these kind of questions after the complete develop. So it is a waste of time, waste of resources, waste of money for the company. So what they basically will do is, they will get a clear cut information with the screenshots, and they will get a sign off from the customer. That means Chaitanya developing a complete product, he will get and confirmation, or he will get sign up from me. I will say okay to all the screenshots, then only you will start the developing the product. So now we have collected the requirements. Next, in the collection of requirements itself, we are developing a different kinds of documents here. First thing is, we have developed a business requirement document, that is overall business, and out of that we have picked up some phases and we have developed another document called software requirement specification document. Those document with detailed screenshots and steps we are preparing. We are at that stage now. Okay. I hope everybody is on the same page. So now what is happening? Now we have developed the SRS document. So next we have to go to software design. Okay. What is the software design? So requirement analysis is done. Once the requirement is finalized and we got a sign off from the client, so first step is done. Now we are into second step of software development life cycle. Okay, what is the second step? Second step, what we are actually doing is, in the second step, we will divide that SRS document into sub-level documents. Still, we will prepare some more documents out of that. So, what are the documents we are preparing? So, we are preparing a high-level design document. That means outer level. So, the complete business. So, now in our case, we have considered this IRCTC. Okay, for this outer one, we have said that there should be 5 screens. Out of the 5 screens, the navigation will be, if you click 1, it has to go to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 5 to again log out means it should come out. So these are the high level documents, high level macro level design. So they have developed, after the SRS document, we have developed a high level design. It is in a high level design document where it will have, so what is the technology and how the application will look like. It is still more information. SRS has all the information, but still out of that they will pick up the high level design and then they will again develop a detailed document called high level. Okay. Once a high level document is being prepared, next document what you will prepare is low level document. Lower level document in the sense, what is the name of the field you are giving? So either it should be username or user ID. So what is the name? What is the color? What is the size of the box? What you want to give? So it is very minute information also you will have in the low level design document. That means it is micro level. So if it is, if the data is scrolling here, what color of data it has to, what color it has to scroll, how much data, how much time, everything information will be present in low level. The moment you prepare next level document, it will contain detailed information about this particular document. So do you have any queries, anybody? Any questions? Okay. So let me just go to next one. So now we are in the software design. Out of that we have prepared two documents. One is high level design. The next one is low level design. So once these two documents are done, that means we have got completely enough details for developing a product. Next, we are into next phase called coding. So what is coding? Any idea what is coding? Okay. So basically what we are doing in the coding the first thing. In the coding, whatever the technology we have finalized and based on the screens, okay, we will write a code. So whatever the screens you are able to see the front end, that means here the screen is displaying here, okay. If I am clicking proceed for booking, so let us see what is displaying here. So if I am just clicking this proceed for booking, what is happening here is it is asking me for plan my journey. It is asking for from station to station, journey date and ticket type. Okay. To display this information, I have to do some coding in the back end. So once if I write that coding using JavaScript or HTML language or .NET or Java, whatever technology I use, I have to get this one particular screen, means I have to do some coding. So now in the high level document and low level document, which comes in the second phase, software design. So I have the clear cut information how the screen should look like. And what are the headings, what are the name of the heading, what is the color, what is the dimension, what is the size, everything I'll get the clear cut information. So after that I am doing the coding now. So based on the requirements, I will start writing the code in either the technology like Java, .NET, HTML, JavaScript, different, whatever the technology might be. I'll just start scripting it. I'll just start writing the code. So each and every skin I'll slowly start building it. So I am just writing login screen, plan my journey screen, booking a ticket screen, sign out screen and contact us. Like whatever I have in this thing, I will write a code for each and every thing. Okay. So that is what I will do in coding. Clear? Okay. So coming to the next section. So we are done with three steps. First thing is requirement analysis. Second one is software design. Third one is coding. In the requirement analysis, we are getting a document called business requirement specification. In the second level, we are getting still more documents. Like we are also getting in the first level software requirement specification. In the second level called software design, we are getting a high level document and low level design document. So third step, we are into coding, where we are developing. That means we are writing a code for all the screens which we have in the low level design. So now coding is been done. Now let us go and test the product. So next thing is, once a developer has developed the complete code, okay, he just wrote a code to display the screens and to just insert the functionality. Now comes the next level called testing. Okay, what is this testing? Testing in the sense, whatever the developer has developed, okay, if it is according to the functionality, if it is working, that means it is working perfectly. If it is not, that means it is not working. That means there is an error, there is a defect. So that defect is nothing but, we will also have the same document called business requirement document, where we will divide all these things. So till software design, the testers also will be there here. But coding will be taken care only by developers, but testing will be done by testers. Here where we will differ. So first the development has done, developers has given the complete code to us. And next it started a testing level, where we also have the high level design and low level design, everything with us. So now how are we going to test? The developer has given us the functionality. Now basically we are from testing. What we actually do in testing is, we will also test if it is according to the client requirement or not. So to give an example for this, let us see here. Suppose if I am typing from station as SBC, that means I am getting this junction, okay, and to station as, okay, Mumbai Central, okay. So these two things I am just typing here. If I am giving one some date and ticket type, and if I am clicking submit, what should happen? It should show me the clients list satisfying this criteria. Okay, that is what. Suppose this is one type of testing. So they'll just give this information and check whether the satisfying criteria, like this list, is coming or not. They'll just check that. Okay, if it is not coming, if it is, suppose in the other case, think that, so instead of giving SPC, I am just giving my special characters. And if I am giving click submit, what is happening? It is showing me invalid station. So sometimes the developer, when he is developing, he will not check all this information. Like he will just do that from station to station. If we give a date and then click submit, it should give, it is giving list or not. That is what developer will write the code. So when you are doing a testing, you will do positive case testing, negative case testing, boundary level testing. You will have different kinds of testing. So basically the aim of testers is to break the developer's code. So once the developer code is ready, he will give the code to tester to find out a different cases in it and to log a defects. Defect here is nothing but if it is working as expected by the client or not. Defect is not nothing but the client, the whatever developer is writing also, that is also a functionality, but that is not expected by the client. So the client has given us, if I am giving from station to station and journey date and e-ticket with the correct things, it should give submit. If I am giving wrong things, it should tell me that you have given wrong information or you have given something different information. It should show some message. Okay. So what is I am doing is, so the client at the time, the first instance, developer will not think in all the cases. He will just only write the code only thinking one case. So when the tester is developing a product, or once he is testing the product, what he basically will do is, he will just test in different kind of scenarios and he will log defects. Okay, everybody is clear till this point? Okay. So what is happening is, so now you will have, in the testing, we are in the testing phase now. So in the testing, we'll have different kinds of levels. What is, we'll have different kinds of testing. The unit testing. What is this unit testing? Unit testing is nothing but, this is testing will be done by developer. If I'm saying developer is a team of 10 people. Think that developer is a team of 10 people and you have an application of IRCTC to develop. So that means, one person will develop this particular section. The other person will develop this particular section. The other person might develop other screen. So once that application is that screen is done, they will again combine all the three codes to make a single screen. The other person will be developing other screen. So it is like one person cannot develop everything. So they have to merge the code of different developers to make a screen or to make multiple screens. It is like that. Okay. So now what will happen is unit testing is whatever each developer is making. Suppose think that Harsha has developed this particular code. Okay. So what is happening? He will develop the first screen. Think that Yami has developed other screen. So now they have to check this particular screen is working or not, and next screen is also working or not. So combination of these two screens are also working or not. So they have to do each and every screen functionality check. That is just an unit testing is your module or your screen you are just checking, ensuring that it is working properly with the proper credentials or not. You will not check with the negative things. First you will check with the positive things. Okay. So once these two screens are getting developed, you will just check. Unit testing is nothing but each unit you will test, which is present with you. You will just check that each unit and then you will verify whether it is working or not. That is called unit testing. Okay. So coming to the benefits of unit testing is nothing but you will ensure that it is working or not, and then you will and the case can be the main benefits of unit testing is once you merge the different other screens, there is a chance that it might work or it might not work. But what you can basically ensure is nothing but you can see your screen is working properly or not. That's it. So coming to the next thing, integration testing. What is this integration testing? Integration testing is nothing but modules. If you see IRCTC here, you will have different modules. Here booking a ticket is there. Let me just click. Okay. Let me just give the two station. It is okay. Let me click submit. So here searching screen till booking. So if I just click here, there is an option called book now. So here this is search functionality. This is the retrieved list. Out of that, I am just connecting to another module called book now. So what is happening is I am just integrating two modules here, searching with booking a ticket. So if I combine these two screens, whether they are working properly or not, that is called integration testing. Integration testing is nothing but combining two modules. Each module will work separately perfectly fine. But if you combine these two modules, whether they are working or not, that is called integration testing. You will integrate two different modules and then check it is working or not. So once you book a ticket here, so next module is cancelling ticket, whether you will be able to cancel or not. That means the booked ticket has to retrieve present in the cancellation list also, so that whether you will be able to cancel the ticket or not. So there is a dependency between the modules. And then that dependency or integration of two modules you are checking basically integration testing. Clear? So that is called integration testing. So coming to the next one. So now I am in the third section. First thing is requirement analysis. Second one is software design. Third one is coding. I am in the fourth one, testing. So out of the testing, we have different kinds of testings like unit testing, integration testing, system testing is there. Basically they'll say, so that system testing is nothing but inside that system testing we will do these kind of testings like integration testing, component testing, different kinds of testing. But everything what basically we do is we'll check the functionality in phases. That's it. So coming to the next one, smoke testing. What is a smoke testing? Smoke testing is now nothing but whenever the developers will give the code sometimes, right? That means the screens, at least one screen also will not work properly. That means how basically we'll have is think that they have given us a IRCTC site for a testing. Okay. So because it is all, this application is already into the live, I can see the screens like that. But if it is very newly developed application, I cannot see the position and the application will be this much good enough. It will be little fluctuating. The application functionality will be little fluctuating. That means when I try to enter the details, it might enter or it might not enter. So there will not be any standard kind of thing. So the moment I get a build, that means I will get an URL each time. to test an application. So the moment I get an URL, I'll just verify whether I am able to log in or not. If I'm clicking book my ticket, what is happening? Like am I getting it is not displayed or it cannot be done, or if the application is not site is not up or down, it is saying application is down. We'll get different kinds of issues. So smoke testing in the sense, we'll not do the entire testing. The moment they give us the code, we'll just check whether at least some functionalities are working or not. So after that, if it is working, we will take up for testing. If it is not working at least the high level functionalities also, then we will not take the testing that particular code for testing. So the developer will not do the complete code also for testing. They will give you some phases. So when they are giving phases also, out of that at least some functionality should work. It is not like the entire thing we are expecting. At least 2 to 3 modules functionality should work. So smoke is nothing but the name itself, it will say. So instead of checking the complete things, at least something should work, then only we can take it up for testing. That is for smoke testing. Sanity testing is nothing but it is also a different kind of testing, where application they have given us, but they have made some changes to the application. Because of the changes, whether actual things which are working earlier is working properly or not. That means think that, see, IRCTC is already working fine. Think that they have added some extra things like tour packages, another thing. So because of the tour packages, what will happen is existing which is working earlier also, it might sometimes not work. So because of added functionality existing might not work properly. So that is called regression testing. Basically we will do, that is complete testing, but we will check because of this one, is it impacting the existing one at a higher level, and then we will take it up for testing. That is called sanity testing. Okay, so coming to the system testing, I told you system testing, basically we will do all these kinds of testings in system testing. So main aim of testing is to avoid all the kinds of functional defects, and there should not be much defects at all. 80 to 90% of the functionality should be working fine. Okay, 80 to 90% of the application has to come in. So 90% of major functionality should be working fine, and system has to be stable. System has to be stable in the sense, that means, see, when you are using this application, IRCTC application, at an Tatkal time, what will happen? You might get some errors like 505 errors or 404 errors, 502 page cannot be displayed. Why all these errors are coming? Because your application is not able to tolerate the load. That means, see, Tatkal you will not be booking the ticket. You will have around 1,000 people or 10,000 people from different locations around India are trying to book the ticket. So at that time you might get these kind of issues like your system cannot handle all this information. That is because your system cannot handle. So system testing is nothing but the testing will be completed only when there will not be no functional issues, there are no stability issues, and there should not be any defects outstanding, major defects outstanding. It should be completely fine. So then they'll give a sign off from testing. So inside testing, you will also have other types, like you will also have non-functional testing. You will have other kinds of testing also. Okay. So inside that is system testing, you have... So what is happening here is like inside the system testing, you will have two types of testing, like functional testing and non-functional testing. In the functional testing, as I told you that we will do integration testing, component testing, all these kinds of testing you do in functional testing. Coming to the non-functional testing, what we basically do is we'll do the other side of testing. So till now what we are doing is like, suppose if we have the functionality, if you are giving username password, whether you are able to log in or not, that is functionality. So if you are not able to log in, that is it is against the functionality, so you will log a defect. So functional testing is nothing but you will concentrate only on functionality. So this is the thing, whether it is working according to the requirement document or not, that is only thing you will do in functional testing. So coming to the non-functional testing, you will not check the functionality perspective. You will check in a different case. What is a different case in the say in is nothing but in the non-functional testing, security testing also we will do it. in this is not a functional testing. Now what I am now talking, this kind of testing is non-functional testing. Okay, what is non-functional testing is nothing but we will do security testing. Security in the sense, now we have a banking website, ICICI Bank. Okay, ICICI Bank website is there where we will actually send money to other accounts. Okay, this has to be secured. Otherwise, we are seeing a different things like hackers hack the online accounts and then transferred money to their personal accounts. So we will see different kinds of things. So basically, when ICICI is developing or designing its site, it has to do security testing. Security testing in the sense, when the data, you know, database might be, database is nothing but where their backend data is placed, the account information, the customer information, everything. So it should not be hacked by third party, whether it is secured or not. So when a person is accessing the data from other location, how the data is getting accessed to. So they will also do security measures, keeping in mind. So whether the all the security measures is being incorporated or not. So before making the application live or before the application being deployed, what they basically check is, they will also check the security measures has been incorporated in the application or not. That is one of the kind of non-functional testing. Other thing is performance testing. So whether my system is able to handle multiple people at the same time or not. So that means IRCTC Tatkal is an example. Suppose 10,000 people are trying to book a ticket at morning 10 o'clock, whether my system is able to tolerate or not. That is called performance testing. And also we have configuration testing. Configuration testing is nothing but whether if I'm giving a print from this ICICI, my printer is working or not. That is called configuration. That means my hardware components, if I'm attaching to this website, it is working or not. So functional testing is one part and non-functional testing is other part. So in the non-functional testing, what we are basically doing is we are checking the other perspectives of the application. So hard performance of a system, and then security of the system, and then hardware, and then compatibility testing. Compatibility means, now I'm able to open the system here in my laptop, and other if I'm able to open in the desktop or not. So this is Windows 7 OS. So it is able to open in Windows 8 or not. So if I'm able to open in an Android phone or not, if I'm able to open this application iPhone, what is happening? So it is like a compatibility testing. I'm just verifying my application is compatible to all the modules or all the phone models or not. So it is like that. So whenever you are making your application live, you will do it or you will check the application in different perspectives. So that is what you basically do in non-functional testing. So you will do recovery testing. Recovery testing means, suppose if the application got failed completely, so have you able to again retain the information or not? If you are able to deploy it, whether you will get it or not. And you will do the usability testing. Usability testing means friendliness. The moment you open any site, if suppose if you open it, so if you, whether you are able to browse to your required information or not, you don't know how much money it will take for this ICICI Bank to open. So to this, you know this information, how are you going? So you will think that this application is not friendly. So usability means it will just check whether you it is a friendliness or not, like whether it is really friendly for you to move to next modules or not. That is what you basically check in these kind of usability testing. So data volume testing, how the volume, how much data you are putting in the database, how the system fastness it is present. So all these are the things you will take care in terms of testing. We are now in the fourth step of software development life cycle. Out of that, we are done with requirement analysis, software design. The third one is coding. Now we are done with testing. So once the testing is done, okay, so this is what I told you, this is what it is mentioned. So once the testing is been done, what is the next level? So once the testing is done, the next level, what we basically do is implementation. What is implementation is, whatever code we have written, that is developers has written and the testers has tested. Now the code is being tested by customer also in the testing phase. They will also do some kind of testing called alpha testing, where the customer will sit beside the developer and he will check whether all the requirements are working properly and he is satisfied with the requirements or not. So once he is able to do that, that means the implementation, they will give sign off for the implementation, the next level. So now they are okay with the code, everything. Now they will implement the code. That means the application is available live in the public. Anybody can use that site. Anybody, so that means the business, anybody can do it. So next comes the phase called, the sixth phase called maintenance. So what is this maintenance? Maintenance in the sense, so when the application is in live, so what will happen is, sometimes you might get issues again in the, when the application is already live. So what will happen is, so they cannot again go back and do testing, all this stuff when the application is live. So they'll have a separate team that is called maintenance and support. That support team, whenever if somebody raises a defect, like the users, basically the users will say, if I am clicking this link, it is not working. So it is the responsibility of the support team to handle these kind of issues, and they have to fix the issues then and there itself. And also they'll do some enhancements. Enhancements in the sense. Suppose they'll have some extra added features. Now, if you see this IRCTC, okay, they have some IRCTC example. If you see here, they have a tool packages which is installed. Okay, tool packages which they have given. So that means an added functionality. So when you have initially developed IRCTC, this module might not be present. So they have added a new module called tool packages. So because there is an upgradation of this, so they are adding new functionality. So this can also be done by maintenance and support. And also the version number. So if you see the version number, in the sense, the moment they develop any application, it might be the version of 1. So if you are doing some enhancements, the version numbers will keep on increasing. Next time version 2, next time version 3, each time you change the application, they will again change the version numbers. Okay, so this is called the bug fixing, enhancement and upgradation. So basically you will do all these steps in the maintenance and support cycle. So with this, I think I have completed the total software development life cycle. Okay, so this is what I have covered, all the six steps in this software development life cycle. So do you have any questions?